Canterbury is a city that's used to welcoming visitors, and the Museum of Canterbury ensures its visitors don't go home disappointed. The museum's theme is the city itself and its often turbulent story.
Canterbury and the museum is full of wonderful stories. One of the new ways we have of actually showing this is called the DigiGuide. It's a small handheld computer.
The father's eyes were filled with terror and hate as he brandished his knife to defend his family, but he was soon overpowered.
The stories are brought to life through computer animation, through film, through people's oral history memories, and through lots of colourful images.
Despite its medieval setting, the museum is very much a 21st century experience. Visitors are encouraged to discover the history of Canterbury for themselves.
I can see a golden thread.
So what we're trying to do is get people to look at history in a slightly different way. So we'd like them to look at the artefacts as if they were an archaeologist or a historian looking at these things.
Have a look. Check the dragon's face. Is it the right way around?
Yep.
And that looks like a leaf print in there, doesn't it?
With a whole room of interactives to explore, budding archaeologists have got their work cut out.
Look, what's he got there, Arabella? What's he got?
Yeah. In this box, you have to try and identify things, and I found a bow.
Thomas Becket is synonymous with Canterbury, and the museum has a unique way of telling his story.
We're very, very lucky to have this strip cartoon, 60 feet long, painted by Oliver Postgate, which tells in a modern and lively way the amazing story of St. Thomas Becket. One of my favourite scenes shows Thomas lying with his blood and brains scattered all over the paving stones. The monks have gone off to get a stretcher, and the people are scrabbling round like ants, picking up bits of blood and brains to take home.
Darling, he said, I put our name down, he said, to take some evacuees. He said, I don't know when, and these little girls arrived on a Friday afternoon.
The museum's World War II exhibition commemorates what happened to the city and its people during the war years.
We went out and spoke to local people and got them to give us a lot of their memorabilia from the wartime years. There were a lot of their reminiscences were recorded, and children could listen to what the people went through who might have been similar age to they are now.
Look at the emergency suitcase you had to take into the shelters with you. Can you see what's in there?
One of the exhibits we've got that children really like is the evacuation suitcase that children would have had standing by during the war if they were ever sent to a safer part of the country. And they can look and see what sort of things kids from 1940s would have had and compare it to their own lives.
The exhibition gives everyone, old and young, a chance to reflect.
Terrible explosions they were. Oh, it was awful.
I've got a feather.
I've got boots.
I've got a spoon.
Canterbury is a city with a rich and exciting history, and the museum certainly reflects that. So if you want a truly interactive experience and a fun day out for all the family, then this is the place to come.